You're listening to Search the Scriptures Daily, a program in which we encourage everyone who desires to know God's truth to look to God's Word for all that is essential for salvation and living one's life in a way that is pleasing to Him. If you're a new listener or a new viewer of our program, you know, Dave, I have to remind myself from time to time that we actually are recording this visually.
Mm-hmm.
Of course, our cameras are just minute, so and they blend in here, so I forget about that. Except when Gary does chide me for my wardrobe. You know, sometimes my shirts don't fit. Actually, they really wreak havoc with these small cameras that we have. So we just put up with it. You know, it's a new addition to our program, and we're happy about it. I think it's effective. Nevertheless, get back to the subject. If you're a new listener or viewer to our program, for a number of weeks now, we've been discussing the topic of psychology and the church. And why have we spent so much time on this? Well, Dave, as you stated last week in our introduction of psychological counseling into the church, that over the last century, and hopefully I'm quoting you accurately or close, you said last week that you believe that this may well be Satan's most ingenious scheme for undermining the belief in the sufficiency of God's Word. Is that accurate?
Well, I call it Satan's masterstroke of genius.
Yeah, so I was close enough.
Yeah.
Why would you say that?
Well, Tom, I don't know why it upsets people. Well, I can tell you why it upsets people, because most of the Christian colleges and seminaries out there, psychology is a big part. Psychological counseling and so forth. They have budgets that they have to meet. They need the tuition for more students.
Let me document that. The prestigious Princeton Review, I mean, they survey all colleges and universities, Christian or secular schools. And they say that the number two career choice for all college students is psychology.
Mm-hmm. Probably right behind business, is it?
I think so, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, okay. So now what is this, Tom? If we read the Bible, this program is called Search the Scriptures Daily. It indicates to us let me read some verses in, for example, Ephesians chapter 4. I can quote them, but let me make sure I get them right. But this is Ephesians chapter 4. And Paul says, "This I say, therefore, and testify in the Lord, that you henceforth walk not as other Gentiles walk in the vanity of their mind." To the Corinthians, he says, stay away from the wisdom of the world. It's foolishness with God. Mm-hmm. Psychology is the wisdom of the world, as we've said a number of times. Verse 18, this is chapter 4 of Ephesians. "Having the understanding darkened, being alienated from the life of God through the ignorance that is in them because of the blindness of their heart." Okay, this is describing the unsaved. That would include Freud and Jung and Rogers and Maslow and all these guys.
Go right down the list.
They were all anti-Christians, right, in fact, who being past feeling have given themselves over unto lasciviousness to work all uncleanness with greediness. Now, here's the part I was thinking of. "But ye have not so learned Christ. If so be ye have heard him and have been taught by him, as the truth is in Jesus." Now, Jesus said, "Thy word is truth." Jesus said, "I am the truth." But Christian psychology is based upon the idea that all truth is God's truth. And some of it Freud had and so forth. It doesn't sound like Freud had any of that.
Right.
Now, I was just looking at an ad from... I don't see why we should keep names secret, from Liberty University, Jerry Falwell's university.
Dave, you'd be hard-pressed to find a Christian university college that doesn't offer psychology. So make no apologies for it. It's out there everywhere.
Right. And basically what the ad was saying, and it's being hyped on the radio and television as well, you need psychological training. If you want to be a professional, and even they're saying this for laymen, you could do a much more effective job. And don't just keep this to yourself or your friends, but get out and help more people. And the way to help more people is you need psychological training. And we have the following courses, okay? Now, if I just went back one chapter, two chapters in Ephesians where we were. And let's read what it says. And now, therefore, you are no more strangers and foreigners. That's what non-Christians are. But fellow citizens with the saints and of the household of God, and, this is the verse I'm thinking of, are built upon the foundation of the apostles and prophets, Jesus Christ himself being the chief cornerstone. Okay, in whom all the building fitly framed together and so forth. We all know these verses by heart. We've heard them so many times. So what's the point? Well, the foundation of the church is the apostles and the prophets. Mm-hmm. Now, Tom, you're a very bright guy. Tell me, which one of the apostles or the prophets had studied Christian psychology?
I'm stunned, Dave. I'm flabbergasted. I'm speechless.
You can't even Absolutely. Remember which one.
Oh, come on. You're right. It's absurd, except that's where we are now in the church.
Yeah. So if this is the foundation of the church, the apostles and the prophets, and Jesus Christ is the chief cornerstone, he never taught about psychology. He never mentioned it. It only came along in the 1800s. That's quite a long time after the church was founded. Jesus said, I will build my church. And he's been building it. How does he build it? Well, we learn the truth as it is in Jesus. We're taught of him. And remember, we've reminded our audience, one of Christ's names, given to him at birth, of course, his name shall be called Wonderful, Counselor. I would go to Jesus Christ for my counsel and to his word, which is where he is called the living word. When he rides into Jerusalem on that white horse leading the armies of heaven against the Antichrist at Armageddon, he has on his thigh and on his vesture, it says, a name written, the Word of God. We're born again by the Word of God, which liveth and abideth forever. And this is the Word which by the gospel is preached unto you. I'm quoting 1 Peter chapter 1, verses 23 through 25. Now, if this is the foundation of the church, and we're supposed to be taught by Christ through his Word, as the truth is in Jesus, then how is it that 1900 years later, suddenly we're being told, oh, you can't really do your job as a Christian. You can't really live for Christ as you should. You know, clear up your deficiencies or unhappiness or feelings of inferiority, whatever you may have. And you can't really counsel others, not even from the Bible, until you have taken a few courses in psychology, psychological counseling. And where did it come from, Tom? It came from the wisdom of this world. Who invented this? Well, you can name them, but they're not Christians. And there's no listing in any textbook for Christian psychology. You'll find Freudian, Jungian, Rogerian, transpersonal, all kinds of psychologies, not Christian psychology. Why? Because there is no Christian who's the founder of a school of psychology known as Christian psychology.
For more information about the Berean Call, call us toll-free at our order number or visit our website,